So today we are going to solve this another formula problems on the Mason's gain formula. So he has given one network here, signal flow graphs here. So find C of S by R of S by using the Mason's gain formula. Okay, find C of S by R of S by using Mason's gain formula. So he has given one graphs, signal flow graphs. First in this graph we have to see the direction of signal flowing. The direction of signal flowing. So here this arrow mark will shows us the direction of signal flow. See, from this node 1 to 2, 2 to 3, okay, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, again 5 to 9, 9 to 10. This is one way which the signal is flowing. Okay, in another way, 1 to 2, okay, 2 to 6, 6 to 7, 7 to 8, okay, 8 to 9 and 9 to 10. This is another way of signal flowing from input to the output. Okay, so next, is there any other ways we have to see here? So 1 to 2, okay, and 2 to 3, okay, 3 to 8, see here, don't go through 4. So another way is here, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 2 to 3, 3 to 8, again 8 to 9, 9 to 10. This is a another way of signal flowing. So you have to observe one more time here, 1 to 2, 2 to 6, and 6 to 5, and 5 to 9, 9 to 10. So there are, I think, other than this, is there any flows? Or a signal is flowing in forward directions, I think. Other than this, there are. So one more is there. So we have to. Two more. Wait. Next, see here. Okay. 1 to 2. Okay. 2 to 3. 3 to 8. Okay. 8 to 7. 7 to 6. 6 to 5. 5 to 9 and 10. See here, 1 to 2, okay, 2 to 6, 6 to 5, 5 to 9, 9 to 8, 8 to 7, 7 to 6, 6 to 5, and 5 to 9, 9 to 10. So this is one. Next, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 5, again 5 to 4, 4 to 3, and next 3 to 8, 8 to 9, and 10. So in this way we have to see whether the signal is flowing in which way, which directions or in which path. Okay. So here first step is to write the forward path. Forward path. So as we discussed here, 1 to 2, here 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 5 to 9, 9 to 10. This is one forward path, that is one that we have to represent it with the P1. So forward path gain. So here it is 1 into G1 into G2 into G3 into G4 into 1. So that P1 is equal to what? G1, G2, G3, G4. So similarly in second forward path, 1 to 2, 2 to 6, okay, 6 to 5, sorry, 6 to 7, 7 to 8, 8 to 9 and 9 to 10. So this is second forward path, 1 to 2, 2 to 6, 6 to 7, 7 to 8, 8 to 9 and 9 to 10. So forward path gain is here, P2 is equal to what? 1 into G5, G1, it should be a G6, not a G1, okay. G5, already G1 is here, it should be a G6, G5, G6, G7, G8. So that G5, G6, G7, G8. So this is the forward path gain for the second, okay, second forward path, okay. So similarly, so here third one what he has given, here 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 8, 8 to 9, 9 to 10, here 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 8, 8 to 9 and 9 to 10. So for this we have to write the forward path gain, that is P3 is equal to G1, G8, G10, here. 1 into G1 into G10 into G8. So that is a forward path gain. So next one is 1 to 2, 2 to 6, 6 to 5, 5 to 9, 9 to 10. See here. 1 to 2, 2 to 6, 6 to 5, 5 to 9, and 9 to 10. So what is the forward path gain for this? G4, G5, G9. G4, G5, G9. So 1 into G5 into G9 into G4. That's why G4, G5 into G9. So the 1 into G5 into G9 into G4 into 1. So this is a forward path gain for the loop, forward path 4. 4 number. That is represented with P4. Okay. So now another one is 1 to 2, 2 to 6, okay, 6 to 5, 5 to, see here, 1 to 2, 2 to 6, okay, 6 to 5, 5 to 4, 4 to 3, again 3 to 8, 8 to 9 and 9 to 10. See here, one more time, 1 to 2, 2 to 6, 6 to 5, 5 to 4, 4 to 3, again 3 to 8 and 8 to 9 and 9 to 10. Okay, so this is a P5. Similar way, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, okay, 3 to 8, 8 to 7, 7 to 6, 6 to 5, 5 to 9 and 9 to 10. See here. 1 to 2, okay, 2 to 6, next 6 to 5, 5 to, okay, this is over now. 1 to 2, okay, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 8, 8 to 7, 7 to 6, 6 to 5, and 5 to 9, 9 to 10. So this is another forward path. So gain for that is 1 into G5, okay, G5 to G1, G1 is the G5, G6, G7. Okay, H4, H3, and G9, G4, whatever the gains are there with respect to that flow of graphs, we have to multiply that product will give us here G5, G8, G9, G10, H1, and H2. So these two are the minus into minus plus. So for this, it is a plus P5, G5, G8, G9, G10, H1, H2. Similarly for P6 is equal to G1. G4, G9, G10, H3, H4. Okay, so these are the six forward paths, okay, which are given in this given form signal program. Okay, so you have to carefully watch. If you are carefully watched, you will get the signal flow directions or flow signal. Okay, so next. Next step is to write the loops. Next step is to write the loop. So how to write that loop? Loop is, see here, loop. First loop is 3 to 4 and 4 to again 3. That loop gain that is represented here. See here, first loop 3 to 4, okay, 4 to 3. This is one loop. 4 to 5. Okay, 4 to 5 and 5 to 4. And there it should be a 5, not a 3. 4 to 5, 5 to again 4. This is a loop 2. Again, loop 3. Loop 3 is here. This 6 to 7, 7 to 6. Again, loop 4, 7 to 8, 8 to 7. So L1. This is L1, L2, L3, sorry, L3, L4. So these are four loops. So next you have to observe, is there any other loops? Yes, another loop that here. It is, if you start with this 6, okay. So 6 to 5, 5 to 4, 4 to 3, again 3 to 8, 8 to 7, 7 to 6. See here. It starts with the 6 and end with the 6. Or you can start with this 3. 3 to 8, 8 to 7, 7 to 6, 6 to 5, 5 to 4, and 4 to 3. So this will we can consider it is another loop. So this is one loop. Or you can start with 4. So it is same. Wherever you start, it is terminate in that loop only, that node only. That we call it as a loop. So here one loop number 1, that is L1, L2, L3, L4, and this one is L5. So okay. See here L1, L2, L3, L5. L1, L2, L3, L4, L5. With respect to that gain, so minus G2 H2. How to get this minus G2 H2? So here G2 is there and H2 is there. G2 H2. Okay. G3 H2 H3 H4 H5. G3 H5. So here missing in this figure, here it is missing. So minus G3 H1. G8 H3. G9 H4. So for this, all these are the loop gain for this loops. Okay, so now next step is to non-touching loops. So you can observe here L1 and L3 are the non-touching loops. L1 and L3 are the. So L1 is here and L3 is here. So this L1 and L3. These two are non-touching loops. Similarly, L1, L2, L3, L4. So L1, L3 are non-touching. Okay. L1, L4 are not touching. Similarly, L2, L3 is not touching. L2, L4 is not touching here. So there are 4 non-touching loops. L1, L3, okay, L1, L4, L2, L3 and L2, L4. With respect to that, you have to multiply. L1 and L3 namage ile see here. L1 is multiplying what? Minus G2 H2. Okay, minus G2 H2. L1 is nothing but minus G2 H2. So that you have to get here H2. L3 is nothing but what? G6 H. So these are the non-touching loops. Other than this, you don't have any non-touching loops. Non-touching loop is nothing but it should not have a same or common node for two loops. We should not have a common loop for common node for the two loops. So this is separated with this loop and this is separated with this loop. This is separated with this loop and this is separated with this loop. These are the non-touching loops. Is there any other 3 non-touching loops? No. Only pair of two loops are non-touching. Okay. More non-touching loop are illari. Okay. So that will give us the non-touching loops here. L1, L3, L2, L3, L1, L4, L2, L4. So next, how to get the gain here? Delta is equal to 1 minus. First, write all the individual sums. So L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus L4 plus L5. So how many here? Just you have to observe here. L1, L2, L3, L4, L5. So you have to sum all these loops, individual loops. L1, L2, L3, L4 and L5. So next step is, next one is plus. So non-touching loops. L1, L3 plus L2. L3 plus L1, L4 plus L2, L4 plus minus. So if there are any 3 loops which are non-touching, that means L1, L2, L3, product of 3 loops. So such a loops are not present in this given problem. Okay, that's why I have to write it as a 0. So what it means, if 2 loops are non-touching, that is a pair of 2 loops. So it is a pair of 3. So if any 3 loops which are non-touching to each other, then we have to write here. But we don't have any such loops in this given problem. So that's why you have to write it here 0. Okay. So next 1 minus. So substitute the values of L1, L2, L3, L4 and L5. So we have to substitute here. Similarly for L1, L2 is nothing but G2, H3, G6, H3. So write all these and simplify it. Just you have to simplify it. Okay. 1 plus minus into minus it becomes plus. G2 H2 plus G3 H1 plus G6 H3. Okay. So all this simplification done here. Next. So individual for loop 1, so for part of path 1, we have to write that 1 minus. So for see here, it is the forward path 1. For this forward path, how many loops which are not touching to this path? So how many loops here? If you observe here. So for this forward path, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5 and 5 to 9 and this is the first forward path. So for to this forward path, we don't have we have two non-touching loops. That is L3 and L4 are non-touching loops here. So here we have to write here. So this L3 and L4, these two are the non-touching loops. We have sum of these two. 1 minus delta 1 is nothing but what? For forward path 1, we have to observe the non-touching loops to that forward path 1. So there are two loops which are non-touching to that forward path. That those are L3 and L4. So again, a 0. Two pair of, similarly in this kind, the pair which are not touching. So that is 0. Okay. So next 1 plus G6 H3. Okay. And G2 H4. G7 H4. So substitute this. And delta 2 is nothing but what? 1 minus second forward path. L1 and L2 are not touching for the second forward path. Okay. Second forward path is here. So this is a second forward path. So for this path, these two loops are non-touch to this forward path. So we have to write that L1 and L2. So that's what we have written. So that delta is nothing but 1 minus L1 plus L2. So substitute and simplify. Similarly for delta 3. Delta 3 is here. For this, we have to write the non-touching loop. For this, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 8, 8 to 9, and 9 to 10. See here. So if you go through this, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 8, 8 to 9, and 9 to 10. So if you go through this 3, this is the touching to this node. So we will not take this loop, that is L1. So L2 is not touched to this forward path. L2 is not touching to this forward path. Similarly, so this L4 is touching with this node. This node is nothing but it is touching with that forward path. But L3 is not touched to this forward path. L3 is not touched to this forward path. So far here, L2 and L3 are non-touching loop for this third forward path. So here he has written that L2 and L3. For delta 3, 1 minus L2 plus L3. Similarly here, right there. Next, delta 4. For delta 4, we are having that forward path in this direction. Delta 4 here. 1 to 2, 2 to 6, 6 to 5, 9 and 10. So for this, see here. 1 to 2, 2 to 6, 6 to 5, 5 to 9 and 9 to 10. So these two loops are connecting to this node. So these two loops are touching the fourth forward path, but L1 and L4 are not touching to this fourth forward path. So for that we have to write this. See here, L1 and L4 are non-touching to the fourth forward path. So that we have to substitute it in. So L5. So delta 5, what is the forward path here? Here, 1 to 2, 2 to 6. So for these two forward paths, all the loops are touched. See here, 1 to 2, 2 to 6, 6 to 5, 5 to 4, 4 to 3, 3 to 8, and 8 to 9, 9 to 10. So for these loops, so all the loops are, for this forward path, all the loops are touching. So we have to consider it as a zero loops which are connected to the, so if you are taken this 1 to 2, 2 to 3, so for 3 this loop is touching, okay, for 8 this loop is touching, okay, so for 5 this loop is touching, for 6 it is touching. So all the loops are touched for the 5th and 6th forward path. So for that we have to write that delta 5 is equal to 1 and delta 6 is equal to 1, because these are 0. Because all the loops which are touched for the 5th forward path and 6th forward path. So now after getting all these values, we have to substitute it in a Mason's chain formula. How many paths are there? 5 paths. So for that we have to write that C by R is equal to what? P1 to P5. So P1 delta 1 plus P2 delta 2 plus P3 delta 3 plus P4 delta 4 plus P5 delta 5 divided by whole delta. So substitute these values. P1 is nothing but we know the P1 value and delta 1 value. So So all these are substituted. So and get to these equations. This equation. So this is our final ratio. What C by R is R control ratio for the given signal flow graph. Just we have to substitute and simplify. That is our required control ratio for the given signal flow. Okay. So these are all having the same steps. So you can solve number of problems. So all are having the same steps. First, go through the first. You have to find out the forward path. How many forward paths are there? With respect to that, you have to write the forward path gain. Next step is to find the loops. Loops. Okay. How many loops are there? Next step is to find out the how many non-touching loops are there. The loops which are not touched to each other. Touched to each other. Okay. Next step is to find out the delta value. Delta value. After finding the P1 and L1 values, so you have to find out the delta values. So for that we have equation that 1 minus sum of individual loops plus sum of non-touching loops, that L1, L2 like that, plus L3, L4 like that, okay, but minus next minus sum of non-touching loops, 3 pair loops of that L1, L2, L3, so like that. Delta 1 is representing 1 minus the loops which are not touched to the first forward path, delta 1. Delta 2 is the loops which are not touching to the second forward path. You have to write those loops equations. So after getting all these values, we have to substitute in these equations. We will get the control ratio for the given signal flow graph. Okay. So next, there are some comparison between the block diagram and the signal flow graph. So both are used for the representation of a control system. So block diagram and signal flow, both are used for the representation of signal representation of a control system. Okay. So what is the comparison between these two? So first, block diagram, each element is represented by a block. Yes. If you are using element or component in the control system, that element or component is represented by the block in the block diagram. But here each variable is represented by a separate node. It is not a node. It is a node. Each variable is represented by a separate node. Okay. Next, second, transfer function of the element is shown inside the block. The transfer function, that means that transfer function is output of the control system to the input to the control system. Okay. So that is the transfer function that will shown in the inside the block. Okay. Here the transfer function shown along the branches consisting of node. The transfer function, that G1, G2, G3, G4. So all these are shown along the lines. Okay. See here. This is the transfer function which are shown in this signal flow graph. So here G1, G2, G3, G4. But in case of a block diagram, this G1, G2, G3, G4 are all shown in the one block. Inside that block, we have to write the G1, G2, G3, G4 like this. See here. So go through the block diagram. See here. In the block diagram, we have to write the G1, G2, G3 in the block. Okay. But in the signal flow graph, we have to write it on along the signal flow line. So that is the comparison. Okay, this is transfer function of the element is shown inside the block. Transfer function is shown along the branches consisting of nodes. It is not a node. Nodes. Okay. Summing point and take-up points are present. So in the block diagram, what happens? The summing point and take-up points are present. Summing and take-up points are option. So instead of the summing point and take-up point, we have to representing those in terms of nodes. Summing point and take-up points are present in the block diagram. So in the block diagram, we are representing the summing point and take-up point. But in a signal flow graphs, by eliminating that summing point and take-up point, just we have to representing with it nodes. Okay. Next, feedback path is present from output to the input. So in the block diagram, feedback path is present from output to the input. So if you are consider any block diagram, there is a feedback path. It is from the output of the control system to the input. But instead of feedback path, various loops are considered for the analysis. We can get so many loops, that L1, L2, L3, L4 like that. Okay. So C by R for find G by 1 plus or minus GS is used. To get the control ratio, we have to use this formula. So G divided by 1 plus or minus GH. So in this, to get the control ratio, that Mason's gain formula, you can use that P1 plus P1 delta 1 plus P2 delta 2 plus so many things, Pn delta n, okay, divided by delta. So method is complicated and the time consuming. Yes, in each step, so we are going to reduce the blocks and we have to draw it repeatedly. So reduction of the block diagram again, in each step we can carry out one method to reduce, or one techniques to reduce that block diagram, and that block diagram is again drawing each step. That is our time consuming and it is somewhat complicated. It is somewhat complicated, but no need to modify signal flow graphs to retain the control system. There is no modifications, or there is no need of draw the signal flow graph repeatedly. Just we have to draw the forward path and draw the loops. Okay, these two diagrams you have to draw, but in the block diagram you have to draw it repeatedly. In each step you have to draw the repeatedly. Okay, so this is a comparison between the block diagram and signal flow graph. Okay, with this we are going to complete the your session. Okay, and thank you.